a young nation building its future. After 20 years of civil war in Sudan, the South voted in favor of independence. This summer, it will officially become the 54th African state. After two decades of conflict, South Sudan is faced with major challenges, including the lack of qualified medical staff and healthcare facilities.
First, there's the rainy season, which systematically leads to flooding and population displacement. Then, every year, there's malaria. And in April, so next month, the hunger gap period sets in, and the number of cases of malnutrition explodes. After that, as of July, we'll start seeing cholera.
With large numbers of southerners having returned from the north in recent months, there is increased pressure on health facilities in the region. More than 750,000 people live in northern Bahr el Ghazal state, and healthcare needs are considerable. However, there is only one general hospital in the state, and that's here in Awil. Médecins Sans Frontières has been working in northern Bahr el Ghazal since 1998. Teams are running pediatric, maternity and nutritional programs here, a decision made in response to alarming figures. For example, one woman in two dying following a caesarean section.
The maternity ward here does about 70 births a week, so it's pretty busy. Probably the biggest thing I've seen in the less than 2 weeks that I've been here is a lot of threatened abortions, incomplete abortions, and stillbirth. That seems to be the majority of the problem that occur here.
Today, the team tended to Ewin, a young woman who lives an hour away from Awil Hospital. She arrived having already been in labour for several days. She had a caesarean section.
A girl?
Yeah.
Like Ewin, 3,000 women gave birth in Awil Hospital in 2010.